Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your financial market wrap-up for this Wednesday, the 8th of May, 2019. Now, in talking to you, I know already I'm not going to be in the office Thursday afternoon. There'll be none of these videos. It's that simple. I'll be back in the office Friday morning. I will be here in the morning. I will have my normal subscriber video out and all the other things. I have an appointment all afternoon that I have to be out of the office on. It's rare that I miss putting these out, but that's the way it is. As you know, trying to figure out the chart action now. Why? Everything's going to depend on the U.S.-Chinese trade deal. Everything. And how the market goes from there, I'll let you figure that one out. You're down right now about 2% in the S&P for the week, down 60 points. You can see how the action has been dropping on the daily charts. The pattern has been one of lower highs, lower lows, and the market is under the 18-day average of closes, which is a resistance point. How much of a resistance point? I don't know. And the reason is I don't know what's going to happen with this trade deal and how the markets will react. I think the big surprise would be getting a deal done. I think the market still, if there's no deal done, have you priced in enough of the negative? That's going to be the question. You're fighting a battle where you should, at the lower Bollinger Band. You tried to extend through it yesterday, got thrown back, and same thing today. If this gives ground, this whole area, the 200-day average is the next support, and under that, the 100-day. When we come over to the momentum of the slow stochastic, it's down. So trend down, price down, have hit a first target, fighting a battle there, and the next step is not the chart, it's going to be what happens with this Chinese-U.S. trade deal. In the NASDAQ, classic again. Lower highs, lower lows, went down to the lower Bollinger Band, no follow through. Momentum still pointing down, not oversold. If you break down from here, the 200-day and the 100-day could be the next target zones. Obviously, if you knew nothing else, this is an area where the market's trying to hold. In the Dow, market's fighting back to get back to that Bollinger Band, but you've got a trend that's down, the market's not getting a lot of follow through, and you have momentum down. Obviously, again, it's all about this trade war. The market that's acted better than most, and whether it can hold up, I have my own doubts, is the Russell. It's really trading against the 18-day average of closes. It had a couple of spikes to the upper Bollinger Band, could not do anything with it if you look, and you have fallen back to trade between the 200-day moving average and the 18. Take out this 1572.50, I don't know where 25 came from, 1572.50 and watch out below. You put into play the lower Bollinger Band with momentum turning down, who knows where it could go. It would also turn the trend down. In the VIX, I'll say what I said from really Sunday on. I don't think the pros are doing their normal selling of Bollinger Bands that I'd expect because this is such a major event. I think the smart money has been buying insurance and driving this up, if you will. And I think the pros are very, very much sidelined from selling puts or calls right now. In the bond market, you can see where the resistance is, the upper Bollinger Band. You pulled back. You're overbought. We know that's a resistance zone, but will people run for safe havens because of these U.S.-Chinese trade talks? And I'm talking much further running. You can figure that one out yourself. This isn't about chart action right now. This is more about an event. When you take a look at the 10-year note, you got higher highs, higher lows. You're fighting right where you should. If it were a normal time, I know what I'd be saying in this video. It isn't a normal time. I don't know which way traders are going to look at this. Same thing in the TLT. You had, I could even call this, you know, a big reversal day. I don't know that I'd call it a key reversal. You're not over those highs. But it's certainly a large reversal right where you'd expect it, at the upper Bollinger Band. Did the market get enough insurance put in it or not? Don't know. In the dollar index, lower highs, higher lows, and battleground 18-day average of closes. Eurocurrency, higher lows, lower highs. There's nothing going on here that I can see that's a trend right now. You'd think the British pound held up. It didn't. It took out 130.13. It took out that low. So this move to the upper Bollinger Band has now petered out. You're out of a trend. You've got, if you will, a higher high and a lower low day, and basically fighting at this 18 and 100-day average of closes. There, I can tell you, Miss May's got her hands full. She's meeting with what's called the 1922 Committee. Big problems going on there. They want her basically, I think they're trying to get her out of office. She said within 2 weeks she'll bring up another Brexit vote. Already everybody's saying, what's the point? Pretty crazy. June Japanese yen, you're at a key resistance number, the 100-day average. We had talked when you got over this Bollinger Band, would the market get any follow through? It did a bit yesterday, so I'll still say that was the resistance, and you went there and you sort of stalled. The trend is up. This is where people, again, safe haven play, that's where they seem to be putting money. Bitcoin, still see this market as bullish. I see the higher lows, higher highs, running of the Bollinger Band top. It is overbought, but the market still has a good look to it overall. In the Brent versus WTI crude, still narrowing in. Now, it gotten up near about 880, and it's pulling back to the 815 level. You can see that the pattern, this day right here that I'm pointing to, you had an outside day up. You've pulled back to the lower Bollinger Band. You're not following through one way or the other. Gee, I wonder if that's U.S.-Chinese trade. Then you get to the July WTI, and all you've done is move back into the Bollinger Bands, but just like the Brent, you got this big outside day up, so you got a higher high, lower low. There's no trend here. In the rebob, now rebob's different. I think the pros are taking some money off the table right now. I don't think they're quite as bearish. Driving season's ahead of us, and I think you've had this big 10 cent or so correction, actually 15 cents, where the market may be at a point where it's trying to find, can it find any support? In natural gas, I think that today's action was very important. Instead of following through to the downside, and it was not trending, remember we had a swing line that had higher highs, higher lows, that ran into resistance at the 18-day average. Today was a big reversal. Now the market is questioning, can it get over this high of 261.80? Weather patterns were about due for a change. We're already at May 8th. Sooner or later, you're gonna get warm in spots, and then the question will be, what do we have in storage in the natural gas? What are the demands? And tomorrow we're going to get an important EIA number. But I don't think tomorrow's number is as important as what the weather forecasts are going to be. Remember that one thing that I do is I put out in the morning my subscriber video. Now, we're making a change to it, so don't disappear so fast. You know, I'm covering 40 charts in the morning of futures, 5 ETFs. Well, one of the hardest things is in the recording in the bottom of it, you drag your cursor. If you want to get to the middle of it, where's the middle? Well, here's what we're adding. When you move your cursor over it, it's going to tell you if you're in the grain section, the meat section, the financial section, metal section. It just move it there, click, bang, you're right into that section. So not only are we given an awful lot of information on it, because I'm able in that one to say buy here, sell there, put a stop here, exactly what I think you should be doing, but we're even making it better, easier to get around. Hope you appreciate it. If you haven't tried it, you go to our website, www.irepstein.com, go under education or research. It explains itself in detail. You can always call my staff too. Inexpensive? Yeah, 26 and a half cents a day to give it a try. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a good day. I'll see you on Friday.